Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO, DBC Technology, and I've got an awesome one today. Today we're going to review the new UniFi Express 7. So it's a really awesome day today. UniFi is dropping three awesome new routers. And here is the entry-level UniFi Express 7, which is an update of the super popular UniFi Express. So let's jump into the specs real quick. The UX7, just like the UDR7 and the UCG Fiber, has that 10 gigabit WAN interface. So you're gonna be able to take advantage of super high speed internet. Now the IDS IPS pass-through is only 2.3 gigabits per second, but that's good enough for most people's internet provider at this point. It also has one 2.5 gigabit LAN port, which is awesome. So if you wanna add a switch or any other connectivity there, you do have 2.5 gigabit for that as well. The other real headliner besides the 10 gigabit WAN port is the integrated 6-stream Wi-Fi 7, which gives you that 6 gigahertz goodness. This is going to be a huge draw, and obviously the 6 gigahertz puts you in a position to take advantage of that. Unlike the UDR7 and the UCG Fiber, this only runs UniFi Network, which is awesome. You don't need a cloud key or anything else. This can control itself. But if you do want to run Protect or Access or Talk, I would recommend getting the UDR7 or the UCG Fiber instead of this. But that being said, it does run network, so you're going to be able to add WAPs and switches and all the other UniFi stuff and control them on this device, which is awesome. It supports up to 30 UniFi devices and up to 300 clients. So with that, you're going to be more than enough to run a large house, no problem. It's a very simple design. There's a reset button on the back, a USB-C input, a 2.5 gigabit LAN port, and that 10 gigabit WAN port. With that, plugged in the power, plugged in the LAN port to my network, and the WAN port to our cable modem, and then fired up the UniFi app on my phone. It very quickly found the unit. I just clicked adopt, put in the user and password, adopted it to my UniFi account as normal, and then it proceeded to do some updates. From beginning to end, that whole process probably took less than 5 or 10 minutes. Very simple. And then boom, as soon as it's done, it just fires you up into that UniFi interface that we all know and love. Obviously, super easy. If you've never had a UniFi device before, it couldn't be any easier. Also, if you are upgrading from another device, you certainly can back up that one and restore that config to this device. Works seamlessly to do that as well there. I just went to the option of starting a fresh one instead of restoring from backup. Obviously, you could see when I was adopting the unit on the speed test that I only have 1 gigabit internet through Comcast, but it is doing the IPS and IDS on that, and I'm getting a really nice throughput on the device itself. Obviously, today in 2025, 2.3 gigabit IPS IDS throughput is pretty good. But you know, if you do have higher needs, maybe let's say you have 5 gigabit Ethernet connection, then maybe I would say to go to the UCG Fiber over this. But that being said, I think for most, this is more than enough throughput there for this device. Like the UX before, this device has a couple party tricks up its sleeves as well. If you wanted to extend your network, let's just say you had a UDM, UDM Pro Max, or UCG Fiber, and you wanted this to be a secondary device providing Wi-Fi to another area, you could run this wired back to your main router, and it would work as a wireless access point. And you could also use this as a mesh device, meaning it will connect to your wireless wirelessly, obviously, and then give you that LAN port to add more devices over on that other side. So let's just say you have a large house and you wanted Wi-Fi in a spot that you can't run another cable to, but you have Wi-Fi access. You could put this device there, connect to your Wi-Fi, and then run a switch off of it or cameras or whatever you wanted to off of that one LAN port that is on the device. The ability uses a wireless bridge or a wired bridge or as a standalone router make this a super versatile little device. So who do I think this is for? Obviously, for anybody that's looking to get into the UniFi ecosystem, I think this is a wonderful starting point. You're kind of future-proofing yourself with the high-speed WAN. You're kind of future-proofing yourself with the Wi-Fi 7. For $199, I think this is the perfect router for an apartment, for a small house, anywhere where you aren't going to run cameras with Protect, aren't going to use phones, aren't going to use door access. I think this is a great jumping off point for the UniFi ecosystem. The great thing about this is it's using the same firewall. It's using the same network app that you are on a $2,000 Enterprise Fortress Gateway. You know, this is a lot of horsepower for a little price. Also, I would think it would be great for anybody running an Airbnb. I did a video last summer when we were in Colorado about the perfect kind of apartment slash vacation home setup. I think this would fit perfectly in this. As a matter of fact, I will probably bring this with me to Colorado this summer and run this as well. I was able to run a VPN back to my home, run all my normal apps, everything really smoothly, very easily. This device would be perfect for that as well. Anybody with an RV, if you have mobile internet with like a T-Mobile router or a Starlink or whatever, like the T-Mobile hotspot we use here for failover, this would be a perfect device for that. Connected to it, you'll be able to do all the cool networking stuff. So perfect for adventure, RV kind of stuff. And also pretty cool for somebody that just wants to learn the UniFi ecosystem but doesn't want to spend $400 or $500 at this point. I think this is the perfect device for you. I will say that like the UX, this is probably going to be a super popular device. If you do think you want one, I would click the link down below. That is an affiliate link. I do want to thank UniFi for sending me out this unit to review. No money changed hands, and all the opinions in this video are mine, but I do get a small little affiliate commission if you do purchase it down below. That being said, though, I think at this price point, all the features that are involved with it, they're going to have trouble keeping this in stock. So if you do want it, I would buy it quickly. You know, my theme for UniFi this year has been about choices. They seem to be going back and filling every little slot. You know, it's $50 less at $149 for the UX. Now you got $50 more to these UX7. You've got the UCG Fiber and UDR7 above it. And at the same price, you've got the UCG Max. So if you need some more of that functionality and not the wireless, you've got that there. But again, it seems like UniFi is filling in all these little gaps and giving you these options at basically $50 price increments, which I think is really awesome. What UniFi is doing is it's giving you the ability to pay for the items that you really want and not pay for the things that you do not want. And ultimately, that makes for happy consumers. So with that, do you have any questions? Please put them down below. I do try and get to all of them. If you have any comments, suggestions, put them down there as well. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.